Hello friends, welcome to AKS. Today we will be dealing with 21st of August Hindu editorial discussion. Let us start the discussion. Today, that is 21st of August, the articles in Hindu are not very important. They are either redundant or they have been repeated. So I will not waste your time. We will discuss the most important facts and we will deal another topic called electric mobility. I have made a separate video on it. You can watch that. And coming to this discussion, the first article here, Trump calls, that is to say that India is opposing third party mediation on Jammu and Kashmir, that we are not interested in US intervening into our Indian politics. This is about the article. We will just know the facts. The second, free fall. Afghanistan is at its lowest. We'll see this. The next is choppy waters lie ahead. This is about Article 370 and its aftermath. There are no new points in this article. We have discussed this article in detail earlier. Please watch 6th of August editorial discussion. The next, a top post, its promise and peril. It's about Chief of Defense Staff. We have discussed this yesterday. There are no new points. So we'll leave this. The next article, the monk who shaped India's secularism, though we will not get any direct point, so it is not necessary for the exam. This is not an important article and this is also not an important article. So let us start the discussion. So Trump is bothered about India and Pakistan as they are both nuclear countries. Conflict between both of them may disrupt the world peace. He has advised both Prime Minister Modi and Imran Khan to reduce the tensions in between. As we know, after revocation of Article 370 and making Jammu and Kashmir as a union territory, Pakistan is trying to raise this issue in different platforms. So Trump spoke to Imran Khan. He said, maintain moderate rhetoric with India. That is, do not get into conflict situation. But you understand that Jammu and Kashmir revocal and claiming that POK is ours has raised tensions in Pakistan. So Pakistan is crying foul that India is changing its position. We have seen that we have changed our strategic doctrine. Sudden change of doctrine is a fear to Pakistan. Why is Trump bothered about it? Because India and Pakistan both have contacts with US, and America is fighting a losing war in Afghanistan. It is fighting this war from 18 years with no substantial progress, and it is desperate to leave Afghanistan as soon as possible. But unfortunately, it needs Pakistan help to come out of Afghanistan. So it is not able to directly pressurize Pakistan, but it is trying to negotiate with Pakistan. So Pakistan is trying to make a prism that Kashmir is a roadblock to Afghanistan. The US also knows that India plays a very significant role, and this role cannot be undermined. But US has its own problems. It needs to find Afghan escape route. But Trump is highly sympathetic to India, and it also says that we will negotiate the deal between India and Pakistan. India, on the other hand, has clearly opposed any third party intervention. Reinforce that Jammu and Kashmir is strictly an internal matter. So the world is now looking at New Delhi, how Jammu and Kashmir will be assimilated into India. This is about the article. We have said in different platforms that Jammu and Kashmir is our internal matter. We do not want any third party negotiations. We will decide on how we will treat our neighbors. The next article, Afghan free fall. See, there is a very tragic incident recently on Saturday in Kabul, capital of Afghanistan. Almost 63 people were killed by a blast by Islamic State. We have seen ISIS has been crunched in Iraq, and now it is reviving in Kabul. This is a cause of concern. When the US is in a hurry to come out of Afghanistan, raising influence of ISIS is a threat to both Afghanistan and the world peace. The ISIS has claimed that we have attacked this. It has become a three-way conflict between the government, Taliban insurgents, and the global terrorists. The present government could be termed as a democratic government, but it is not able to ensure the safety and security of the people. IS presence in Afghanistan eastern side, an area called Nangarhar, has emerged as a third player. Attack is on civilians and Shia minority. If we observe closely, the attack was concentrated on Afghanistan's Hazara Shias. This community was attacked by IS. The complex, mutually destructive nature of conflict is the biggest challenge now. See, if we look at the history, Soviet Union came out of Afghanistan in 1989. It burnt his hands when it entered and came out of Afghanistan. Now even the same US is also in the same position. Now there is a shift that global terrorists like ISIS and Al-Qaeda are entering. Now as the US is ready to come out, now the government and Taliban have to decide and settle their differences. Though the Taliban has said that we will ensure peace, we will never know when the America comes out, there is a chance that this could become radical. If we see the IS on the other hand, it has demonstrated an ability to survive and strike in Afghanistan despite US using heavy air campaign in the east. Ideally, in this situation, international community should take some steps. They should have looked into balance of power. This is the crux of the article. See, we have given a lot of development assistance to Afghanistan. We have built their parliament. We have ensured their peace to a large time. US has asked us to enter into Afghanistan, but we are clear on our doctrine that we will not put our boots in the territory. The internal conflicts between Afghanistan and the sorry state of affairs is difficult to undermine. So even the US is trying to come out in a safe exit. So what could be done in this situation? International community and powers like US, Russia, China and India can have a multi-stakeholder discussions and ensure peace to Afghanistan. But without this, Afghanistan will have a free fall. These two articles were little important for the exam, so we have discussed. On this note, thank you very much.